My name is Mark Warren, and in this video, I'm going to tell you how I'm restoring my vision naturally and how I'm doing it so fast. In my last video, I was talking about peripheral triangulation, but now I'm going to take it one step further and tell you how I'm really accelerating my vision restoration progress. I've realized that active focusing and Bates method is the exact same thing. They're both trying to get you to the same point, but they're not explained very well. This is the reason why you have some people that have trouble getting active focus because they don't know exactly what they're looking for, or Bates method people who do the swinging, they don't understand what they're doing in swinging and therefore they don't know how to get their vision fixed. I've realized both of them have the same thing in common, they're trying to get you to the exact same point. So just a little history. I started my vision restoration in November of 2018. My left eye was -5 and my right eye is a -4. Now my left eye also had an astigmatism correction of -1 power and an 80 degree access. Now I'm seeing perfectly clear for 4 and 5 minutes at a time, and it happens throughout the day. So we're talking over 20, 30 times a day that I'm seeing perfectly clear for 4 to 5 minutes at a time. This time is getting longer and longer the more that I go through my vision restoration practices, habits. The more that I work at it, the easier it gets, and the times that I'm getting perfectly clear vision is lasting longer and longer each day. And this is all without glasses, and I've done this in 10 months. My current glasses prescription is -1.5 and a -1.5 in both eyes with no astigmatism correction. I rarely wear my glasses at all. The only time I wear my glasses really at this point is at nighttime when I'm driving. Other than that, I typically do not wear my glasses at all because I can see clear enough and usually clear up things as I'm going throughout my day. I'm going to get right to the point, but I do want to go into a little bit of how your eyes start to fail. The first thing I learned what causes nearsightedness is basically your ciliary muscle locks up. There is a muscle in the eye called the ciliary muscle, and this is the muscle that is responsible for focusing the lens. Now, when the lens is flexed, when the ciliary muscle flexes the lens, it makes the lens tighter, bubbled up. It's like making a fist. And it needs to relax or open up or basically loosen up in order to see at a distance. And this is like flexing a muscle and then relaxing the muscle. It's flexed when you see close up. It should be relaxed when you're looking at stuff far away. What happens is when you start getting too much close up, then the muscle gets stuck. It's like having a muscle spasm. If you've ever had a Charlie horse and you can't open up your arm or release your leg because your leg or that muscle's so tight and it takes forever trying to get that kink out, it's the same thing that's happening in your eye. So that's only part of the problem. Close up is only part of the problem. It's not the full problem. The problem is actually a little bit more than that, because if you think about it, there's a lot of people out there that probably do just as much stuff looking at things close up as you do, but they don't have problems. They're not having to wear glasses. They see perfectly fine, so they could be on their screens and all that. So that's what kind of got me thinking. If it's just an issue of being close up, why is it that some people have the issue and some people don't? Well, it's more than close up, and I've figured exactly what it is. There's a big mental aspect as to why your vision fails. And what made me realize this was the first time that I saw perfectly clear, yet I was supposed to be wearing a -5 and a -4 on my eye prescription. But yet here I was without my glasses, seeing crystal clear. Again, it didn't last that long, but it was like, whoa, what just happened here? So there was a mental block here that we all who are nearsighted do, and we don't realize we're doing it. The cause is due to blocking or ignoring movement between objects, and they could be in your peripheral, off to your side, or in your foreground and your background. I started to listen to my body, and all along my eyes were telling me how they wanted to fix themselves, but I was ignoring it. When I finally started to listen, that's when I started to get it. You can fix your vision simply by noticing movement between objects. So I'm going to read this from the paper just so I'm not forgetting any of my points because I have a whole list of points that I want to go through. So you need to be aware of at least two objects or more and always notice movement between what you're directly looking at and the object that is in your foreground or background or in your peripherals off to your side, left and right. When you notice movement between objects, you see a lot more in your visual field, so all around, and you see sharpest at the thing you're directly looking at. So there are three ways your eyes should see and track movement, and I'm going to explain all three and give you examples of them. There's stationary movement, there's mobile movement, and then there's object movement. So stationary movement. This is the movement when you can only move your head. Your eyes will create movement between a foreground and background object when you're moving your head. So it works like this. If you hold up your finger, one in front of the other, and look at the back one, when I turn my head to the left, the finger in the front appears to move to the right. When I turn my head right, the finger in the front appears to move to the left. So that's part one. If I look at the front finger and I still see the background image or the background view of the second finger, when I turn my head to the left, the finger in the back moves to the left. When I turn my head right, the finger in the back moves to the right. So this is the basic movement that you should be seeing when you're sitting stationary and can only move your head. You should be noticing the object you're looking at and another object either in front or behind it. And as you move your head left and right, and you can do this drill just in front of whatever, put up your fingers two at a time, look at the back one and move, and you'll see the front finger moving side to side, and then look at the front one, and then the back one will move side to side. So you should always be aware of two objects, seeing both at the same time. Now, you're not directly looking at the second object, but you should be aware it's there. And when you turn your head and move it left to right while still looking at the thing you're looking at, it creates movement of either the background or the foreground. The more you're aware of this movement, the sharper your eyes will be, and that your vision will actually correct itself when you start noticing this. So I'm going to change the views here for a second, and I'm going to show you how I have my computer work desk set up. So when I'm working at my computer, you'll notice I have that green water bottle there, my hydro flask, and my monitor there, and of course I've got an eye chart in the background there. This is an example of how you should set up your workstation, especially if you do a lot of reading or working in front of a computer. As I read stuff on the screen and move the screen around, what happens is, and I'm going to come in here a little bit closer so you can kind of get an idea of how I am seeing things as I'm working. Let's say I'm looking at the computer screen. As I'm moving and reading on the computer screen, I'm seeing that green water bottle move like that in my foreground. I'm not directly looking at it, but I can see the movement as I'm reading across the screen, left, right. Then, if I look at my second screen, that water bottle moves to the other side. So again, I see it in my foreground, in my peripheral vision, that water bottle moving as I'm reading across that screen. Sometimes when I'm reading stuff at the top of my computer screen, I see the eye chart. It moves as I move my eyes left or right. So that's the type of movement that you should be seeing when you're looking at stuff close up. The problem is when we're looking at stuff close up and we don't notice this movement, our eyes go into a tunnel vision, and that's what's causing the ciliary muscle to actually lock up. It's because you're not aware of other movement. If you're reading a book and you're so close to the book that you can't see movement of either a foreground object or background object, again, this is what's making your ciliary muscle stuck. So, rule number one, get an object in front or get an object behind that you can see move as you turn your head. You're looking at basically both at the same time, but you have to be aware of that movement of either the foreground or the background object. As you can see, my computer screens are away from the back wall. There's quite a bit of distance actually between my computer screen and the wall. And I also have a backlight there. The light's giving me more stimulation for my eyes so I can see behind or see some depth behind the screen. So that's why I have that light set up there. And of course, I've got my eye chart. But as long as I'm noticing this movement, I haven't had to wear glasses in front of my computer in over, oh, about 6 months now, I think it's been. I stopped wearing my glasses at the com in front of the computer around about the month of January. So actually, it's been longer than that. So it's actually been about 8 months. For the second part, I'm taking this outside to show you mobile movement. This is the second type of movement that your eyes should be aware of. So what I'm going to do, as you can see, I've got a smoker there and there's a tree. They're both in line. So what I'm going to do is actually walk, and as I'm walking, I'm looking at both at the same time. I'm watching them separate. I can still see both in my view as they both separate. Now, when I'm ready to start looking at another object, now I might look at the tree and the license plate there in the background. Now I'm watching them converge. They're both at the same time. And what I'm doing as I'm walking, I'm constantly switching to two new object points and watching them separate. This is the second type of movement that your eyes need to see. Now I'm looking at the plate and maybe the tree behind it. They're starting to merge or be different from each other. Maybe in the background, way there in the back of the trees, I can see these trees, and as I walk, the different trees start to separate. You see how the ones in the background are starting to move. Looks like it's moving versus the ones in the front is standing still. So that type of movement, noticing this anytime you walk around, that's what you should be looking at. You should not just be aimlessly staring in front of you. You should be watching movement between objects. Look at this tree as I walk to the back of the house. I'm looking at the tree at the same time as the corner of the house, and I'm watching how they converge. Now, as I walk this way, they start to split. Now it moves out of view. This again, it's the second type of movement you should be noticing. Anytime you are looking and walking, notice movement. The grill and the smoker, they're together. Now they are diverging apart from each other. If I start to walk back this way, they converge. I'm looking at that movement between the two. This is how you should be looking at things when you're mobile. Now, if you want to do this for an example, walk around for 2 to 3 minutes. Try not to blink and look at stuff just merge in between. Now it's the tree in the shed. As I walk, I look at them kind of split apart from each other. I'm looking at both at the same time. I'm keeping my eyes on both at the same time as they split apart. Do this for 2 or 3 minutes. And then after that, I want you to stop. Try not to blink while you're doing this, but just stop where you're at. Close your eyes for about 5 seconds. Don't close them hard, just close them for 5 seconds. Open, and then do this again for another 2 to 3 minutes of just walking, watching objects as they move against each other. Again, it could be trees. As you can see, you've got trees against trees, and as I move across or walk across, walk in front of them, I'm seeing them move against each other. You see the back ones moving, it's almost like a little bit more than the foreground ones. That's the type of motion that you need to look at all the time, anytime. And then again, after 2 to 3 minutes, stop, close your eyes for about 5 seconds, open them, and do this again. So take a walk every day that you possibly can in bright sunlight and do this and look at movement between objects. Let the objects be in line and then let them separate. Look as far down the road as you can, even if, like I said, and again, we're doing this all without glasses. I'm back inside now because it was very hot outside today. So again, that's the type of motion that you need to see. And what you're going to find, if you're doing that every 2 to 3 minutes walking, you're looking at movement in between objects. They'll be in line and then they'll separate, or they might be separated and then they converge. So they'll either be converging or diverging. Every 20 seconds, 15 to 20 seconds, look at a new object. So you're looking at these diverge, look at new ones that are in line, and then they start to diverge as you walk. Look at that movement between two objects, at least two. Eventually, what's going to happen is you'll start seeing more than two objects at a time, varying the convergence or divergence as you walk along. I could see a tree way in the background over here, maybe a light pole, and then maybe another tree in front, and I can track all of them at the same time. My eyes are that much wider in my visual field is that much wider now that I can track more than two objects at a time. So again, the more you start doing this, the more clear your eyes will get on their own. You won't even have to do anything. What you're going to find, again, as you're doing this, you do this for 2 or 3 minutes, you stop, close your eyes, open, and then you do this again, you will probably feel a stinging sensation. You may even feel that stinging sensation and tearing up feeling in your eyes if you're doing the first example that I was talking about when you're stationary movement. That stinging or that tearing sensation is normal. What that is your ciliary muscle is tight. It's tight like this. And as you're noticing movement, it relaxes your eyes. Your whole visual system starts to go into relaxation mode. The ciliary muscle is trying to open up. It's trying to, I'm finally starting to release. So that's what that stinging sensation is, the tearing up that you might experience. It's the muscle trying to release. The first time it happens, it might be really intense. But if you can push your way through it, the more you can push your way through it, and then finally blink. Blinking will cause it to relax or stop, but you don't see as clear after that. But if you can just hold that as long as you can, then hold your eyes closed for 5 seconds after that, that stinging, that tearing starts, and then open again, you'll be like, boom, wow, stuff is starting to get sharp. It's in focus. It's like, I'm seeing clear. This is what happened to me around about the end of December, January. I was seeing crystal clear, but yet I was supposed to be wearing -4 and -5 glasses, or -4, -5 in my eyes for my glasses. And again, I'm like, how can this be? I'm seeing crystal clear. It was only lasting for a few seconds at a time back then, but I didn't exactly understand how I was getting to that point, but that's what happened with me. I was like, whoa, I just saw crystal clear and I'm not wearing glasses. So now I'm at the point I'm seeing 4 to 5 minutes at a time without glasses. And the more you do this, the more you put this into practice, eventually I know what's going to happen. I already see what's happening. My eyes are just going to go boom, perfectly clear. I don't even have to do all these drills because I'm putting it into habit. I'm doing this all the time. I'm aware of foreground and background movement. Even now as I'm recording this video, I'm looking at the camera, but as my head's moving around, I see we have a curio behind the camera in my office here. I'm looking at that move from left and right. So I'm looking at two objects at the same time. And again, that's keeping my vision clear. You have to track objects and notice movement between. The third type of movement that I'm going to tell you about is objects that are already moving. It could either be a single object or multiple objects. So it works like this. I'm not going to do this outside because I don't have any practical examples for this at the time. I know my street doesn't have that many cars driving by, but say for instance, you see a light pole and you see a car and the car's driving. You're looking at both the light pole and the car at the same time and you watch the car come up to the light pole. They cross and then they go away. So you could either look at the car, stop, look at the light pole, and then in your peripheral watch the car go away, or vice versa. Look at the car, the light pole is in your peripheral, and then the car continues to go by, but you still have the light pole in your peripheral as you're watching the car go by. So this is another way of watching movement of things that are already moving. It could be two cars coming towards each other. Maybe you're driving in a car, you're moving towards the car and the car is moving towards you and they're passing. So there's multiple times where there's things around us that moves and we can watch either a stationary or another object that's moving with it or maybe against it, looking at that convergence, divergence of the two objects as they're coming in and out of your visual field. So those are pretty much the three type of movements. I'm going back to my notes here just so I don't forget anything. So if you're here from End Myopia or if you're a Bates Method follower, Again, this is the same thing. They're both trying to get you to do the same thing. Active focus, I know they start off talking about getting a text or something, and you get to it where you can see it, and then you get to the edge of the blur, and then you move back, and you keep going back and forth and blink a few times until it starts to sharpen up. What you're doing is you're becoming aware of that peripheral movement, the movement between multiple objects. They're not telling you that, and that's why some people can't figure out active focusing, is because they're not aware of this little tiny movement that activates that ciliary or gets it to release so you can see clear. Bates method, the swinging, a lot of people, they just don't get the swinging. When you're swinging your eyes left to right, things like that, they're not seeing the motion as they're swinging. They're both doing the exact same thing. But like I said, nobody clearly tells you how. So even now, as I'm doing this video, I'm looking at the camera, but as I'm turning and moving my head around, I have a curio cabinet that's right behind the camera that I'm seeing move left, right. So I'm looking at two objects doing this the entire time as I'm moving my head around. So that's all it really takes to fix your vision, is to notice this. So I know one of the things I recently saw for in myopia, they were saying that it could take 10 years or more if you're really high myopia to fix your vision, or 5 years because it's a diopter per year. I don't think it's going to need to take that long. It's just a really a matter of getting yourself into the habit of seeing motion between two or more objects. I've only been doing this for 10 months, and it started off just being a few seconds of clarity. And this is without glasses. We're talking, I'm supposed to be -5, -4, and without glasses, about, 8 months ago, I was seeing crystal clear for a few seconds at a time. So now those times are getting longer and longer. I'm up to about 4 to 5 minutes. And so the curve on it, I'm looking at the time frame of how it's all been. The curve started down here at a few seconds, then it went to, maybe 20, 30 seconds. Now, then it went to a few minutes. Now I'm at 4 to 5. And what's happening is I'm noticing it's happening faster, that I can get clarity, perfect clarity. I'm talking no double vision or anything. So what's going to happen is eventually my eyes are just going to be like, okay, we get it now. We're going to just keep everything in sync and not do this back and forth. I don't wear my glasses at all except for driving at night. That's the only time I put my glasses on, and the glasses that I'm wearing are a -5, negative 1 point. Or let me start again. It's a -1.5 on both eyes, so they're both 1.5 on both eyes. And this is from coming from a -5 and a -4, and this has just been 10 months. So I got to a -1.5 in 10 months. And again, I do not wear my glasses except for nighttime driving. And even then, sometimes I don't even wear them at night. I've been pushing my eyes more to see more clear. When I'm out during the daytime, bright sunlight, I don't have my glasses on at all. The way I see right now without my glasses is a little bit of double vision, but as I'm noticing movement as I'm driving around, the double vision will go from, like, let me put my hands down a little bit. It'll be blurred over here, so kind of like a double stacked image, and then it'll go over here and shift over here, and then boom, it's all in sync. And as long as I'm concentrating on noticing that movement, I can make everything out that I'm driving, street signs, license plates, cars, And when it does shift to a little bit of the double vision, it's just a slight ghosted image. So I haven't worn glasses driving in probably about a month now, maybe a month or two. So that's just me personally. I don't say for you to go out and do that today until you're comfortable or whatever. That's on you. But this is for me. This is what I'm doing. So don't take this as go out and drive without glasses. Mark said, no, don't do what I do. But the fact is, I'm seeing crystal clear every day, and I'm seeing longer and longer, and I'm only 10 months in. Like I said, I think, like I said, here sooner rather than later, everything's just going to finally sink all together. Because again, this is a mental thing. If it was a physical thing, everybody would have an issue who got stuck seeing things close up. Like I said, it's just a matter of getting your brain used to noticing this movement all the time when you move your head. So, and that's another thing, don't just move left, right. You can move up, down. If you move your head up, you might notice things move down. You move your head down, things might move up, depending on if you're looking at the foreground or the background image. There's lots of little movements that you can notice between objects. Even like I said, now as I'm panning all around, I'm seeing the curio in the background move with me, and it's actually keeping my vision sharp because I can see my eye chart across the room. So, let's see if I forgot anything. Set up your work area for success. Again, you saw how I have my computer. Take a walk every day and notice movement. You have to keep mentally telling yourself, watch movement between objects. That's what it's going to take to fix your vision. Again, I don't think it needs to take 5, 10, 12 years, any of that. You just have to tell yourself to look at movement. I put together a website with, it has like a journal. I don't journal every day about how my vision's becoming or progressing, but I do every couple of days. I'll put some updates in there, and it also talks about the journey of how I got to this point, where I started and where I'm at now, and the things that I've realized along the way. So I encourage you to check that out. The website is myopiaismental.com. It's all free. I've given you all the things that you need to fix your vision, and you can fix it, I think relatively quickly as long as you're putting these things into practice. So go out and check that out. It's all free there. All the information is there. So there is maybe a PayPal donate button here or there if you want to donate to the site to keep it going, if you're finding this information beneficial. But it's free for everyone. So I'm not trying to make money off of this or anything. I'm just telling you how I fix my vision so I can see clear all the time. Nobody has to wear glasses. They just have to be taught how to use their eyes. So I just want to say a disclaimer. I'm not a medical doctor. I just figured this stuff out. If you have other serious eye conditions or problems other than nearsighted and astigmatism, contact your doctor for that. I can only tell you what's been working for me, and I can't give medical advice on how you need to do about some other type of medical condition. So don't ask. I'm not going to help you on that. But again, all I'm telling you is how to look at stuff, and either you're going to get it or you're not, but work at it. It's going to take work. You've got to work at it constantly. I'm constantly telling myself, stop staring, stop tunnel visioning, stop focusing on one thing. You know, as I'm looking at the computer screen, sometimes I get so sucked in, and I know when I do it because everything goes like this, and I stop seeing the movement of the things that are in front or behind my computer. So I know once I get to the point I'm starting to strain, and I have to tell myself, sit back, close your eyes a minute, open, watch the movement, and then boom, I've got it. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have questions, feel free to drop them down below. Again, check out the website. Lots of information there. I do plan on putting up a few other videos about the journey that I'm on and some other things that might be helpful for you, little drills and things like that you can do. So be sure to check that out. This is Mark Warren, and we'll catch you on the next one. Good luck with your vision, everybody.